Hey guys, before this video starts, I would just like to let you know that this is my second video on YouTube, so at the end of it, if you don't mind, go ahead and comment what changes you think I should make and what part of your video is a favorite, because let me tell you, this video takes you on a roller coaster of different editing styles. Without further ado, let's get you back to your video. It was a peaceful day in Scrap Mechanics, and all I was trying to do is some math on my 8-bit computer when this happened. This thing is trash. It can't add 128 plus 128. What kind of computer is this? So yeah, I'm making a new computer. No, I just finished my first one like 6 days ago, but it's fine. I'm making a new one. Hey guys, welcome back. In today's video, I'll be making a new Scrap Mechanic computer that, unlike my previous computer, will be 16-bit. This will allow for a lot of interesting functionality. And because the size of the computer limits the size of RAM, for simplicity reasons, you'll now be able to store 131.072 kilobytes of memory, which is quite a lot for a vanilla Scrap Mechanic computer. I also plan for it to be able to handle numbers precisely, all the way down to 1 over 32, ranging from positive 1023.9687 to negative 1023.9687. Built-in multiplication and division circuits is going to be quite the feature-rich computer, so let's get started in part 1 with the ALU. In this video, I plan to get the multiplication, addition, subtraction, and division circuits working. Next up, you can see me working on the addition circuits here, and so what I'm going to do is I'm just going to add two 8-bit adders together, and then that's going to make one big 16-bit adder, because the way addition works in binary is it's just a bunch of little 1-bit adders to make up an 8-bit adder, so just combining two 8-bit adders will make a 16-bit adder. And you can see here I tested it to make sure it works, and so it seemed like it worked pretty fine. So moving on to the subtraction circuits, see, it's basically the same thing, you just combine two subtraction circuits. So go ahead and hook that up here, and you can see I tested with some numbers as well, and see that it does indeed subtract. And yeah, that's the two first circuits.
Next up is multiplication. I consider myself to be quite the expert on the topic.
You lied to me. Google!
You said it was gonna be 6, but it's
5.
Bye.
Yeah, it's not that easy. We're going to be doing multiplication through repeated addition, where you add a bunch of numbers and eventually you get an output. The first step is building what I'm going to be calling the distribution array. And what this is going to do is it's just going to distribute whatever numbers I select to the different adders. That way it can add the numbers up and get our output. With this distribution array finished, you can now see that if I type in a number up here, such as 5, and then type in another number down here, such as 3, you can see we get 5 on those first two rows. That's what this one does as well. Type in 5, select the first row, give us it on the first one. Second one, if I do top 2, and on those two. How that's going to work is it's going to distribute them to the different adders. And I'm going to hook them up to the adders, and we'll see where we need to go from there.
Thank you.
Okay, so I went ahead and cut the time-lapse a little short. It was going to be pretty long, but it was mostly disconnecting, so it wasn't very interesting. So I went ahead and finished the multiplication circuit, and now I can multiply up to two 16-bit numbers and get a 32-bit output. So if we do 3 times 3, see, it gets us our output, which is 9. And one funny thing I just wanted to mention real quick is this has 2,240 logic gates, and my first computer had 2,900 logic gates. So this has almost as many logic gates as my first computer, like 5,600. So next down the list is division. And you can see what I did here. My previous computer was just, I had a subtractor and a comparator, and it would just do repeated subtraction to get the quotient and the remainder. The benefit to this is that it's really easy to understand and also very simple in design. The downside is that it's pretty slow, and it's literally called the slow division method. So instead of doing that, I was trying to come up with a design that would be more efficient and a lot faster. The only problem is that with this design is there were a couple of major flaws. One, it didn't work at all. And two, this would have just been massive and would have to have had an insane amount of subtraction circuits for it to work properly. So I have decided on making a hybrid design between the two, where I'm going to have multiple subtractors, but it's going to be the same basic form factor as this one. It's done. So you can see there that I went ahead and finished the division circuit. Over here we have the inputs. This one is the dividend, and this top one is the divisor, so it's reverse what you would expect. Over here is the switch to turn it on. Over here are the outputs. This is the quotient, and then this is the remainder. So I'll go ahead and give a quick demonstration of it working. And I'll simply be doing 9 divided by 2, which, as we know, will be 4 with the remainder of 1. All we need to do to reset it is just count that back, and it'll give us all the other stuff once I flip the switch. And there we go. It is finished dividing, and you can see we got 4 with the remainder of 1. Alright, so let's quickly go over what we've finished so far. We have mostly functional division, fully functional multiplication, and fully functional addition and subtraction. In part 2, I plan to go over the format of the computer and a little bit more of the computer in detail. Alright, thank you for watching, and I'll see you all in the next one. Goodbye. Why are you still here?